Good morning, my dear students, and a warm welcome to all of you in this e-learning program. Friends, in our today's session, we are going to do the textual exercise of chapter number 6, which is combustion and flame. Welcome to Science by Harsha Ma'am. Now, we have already seen the lesson from the Prachi textbook, the revision in the form of NCRT. Now, we are going to see the textual exercise so that if you have any kind of doubt or any kind of problem in the lesson, it gets sorted out. So now, let's move further. Coming to the very first question, as you are already knowing that the question one is very short question answers, in which the answers is written in either a word or a sentence. So here, very short answer type questions you are having. In that, the very first one is, what are the substance which burn in air called? So those substances which are burning, they are called as the combustible substance. So question A, in that first answer is combustible substance. Coming to the second answer. Second one is, what is the lowest temperature at which a substance catches fire called? The minimum temperature at which the substance catches fire is called as the ignition temperature. Try to recall the minimum amount of required temperature is called as the ignition temperature. If the object will reach this temperature, then and only then it will start burning. Coming to the next question, fossil fuels, when it is burnt in limited supply of oxygen, it is producing a poisonous gas. Name the gas. So you already know, any of the fuel, it is burning, it is containing carbon and it will react with the oxygen, and most of the time it is carbon dioxide which is produced. But here oxygen is in limited quantity, so what will be produced? It will be carbon monoxide. Fourth question, which zone of a candle is the hottest? So it is the non-luminous flame which is the hottest, the blue colored flame. Okay, so that is about the next question, that is question number 4. Moving to question number 5. Name two air pollutants that are produced when the coal is being burnt. It is, just now only we saw one of them as carbon monoxide, another one is the oxide of sulfur. So this is about answers to question A. Please note down the answer, and after that we will move on the next short answer type questions, that is in 10 to 15 words. So please note down these answers quickly. I hope you have noted down these answers. Now, let's move further on the next part. The next question that is question answers state two conditions which are necessary for combustion. For combustion to carry out, we need the minimum amount of temperature, that is ignition temperature, combustible substance, and the combustible substance, ignition temperature, and the supply of oxygen. So among these three you can write any two. Any of the two things you can write. Okay, coming to the next answer. What is meant by the luminous and non-luminous flame? So, luminous flame is the yellow colored flame where there is incomplete combustion and it is so only yellow, and carbon monoxide is produced because incomplete combustion takes place. It is producing appreciable amount of light and heat, while if we talk about blue colored flame, it does not produce appreciable amount of light, but ultimately it is having more, it is giving more good energy. So these are two luminous and non-luminous flame. This one is yellow in color. This is blue in color. It is observed when incomplete combustion takes place, while this one is observed when complete combustion takes place. Okay, let's move further on the next particular question. Next, name two damaging effects of burning coal and petroleum. When the coal or petroleum is burned, first of all we know that carbon, whenever any carbon containing thing is burned, it is producing carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide. So the various gases like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, they cause air pollution. and this leads to air pollution. Okay. Now, moving to the further thing, that is the oxides of nitrogen and sulfur. What will they do? They will dissolve with the rainwater and they'll form acid rain. Okay, so this is about the further question, that is about the acid rain. Next, mention any two characteristics that you will consider for selecting the most ideal fuel. So any two characteristics of ideal fuel we can write. First of all, it should burn at the moderate rate and it should be available easily. It should have high calorific value. So any two you can write. It should be cheap and easily available. The next one is it should have high calorific value. So this is about the question B. Okay, more number of answers have been written on the board. Do not worry, you'll get enough time to write it. I hope you're clear with the content with the answers because we've already done this content in the revision. I hope no further clarification is required for this particular answers. Please note it down, then we'll move further on the next particular topic, next particular answer. Okay, note it down quickly. Note it down. I hope you have noted down the content. Now, let's move further. What is acid rain and how does it affect iron structures? For example, you already know that acid rain is the one that is containing oxides of sulfur and oxides of nitrogen. When they combine with the rainwater, and this rainwater when falls on the earth, it is called as acid rain. And this acid rain is tremendously affecting all the iron things because it promotes the corrosion of the iron, and that's how it is damaging all the iron contents. So let us note down what is the acid rain. This is the fifth answer. Acid rain is the rain formed when oxides of sulfur and nitrogen, oxides of sulfur and nitrogen combine with rainwater. It's falling when the oxides of sulfur and nitrogen combine with the rainwater, and they are acidic. The corrosion of iron and marble. Okay, so this is about the fifth answer. Coming to the long answers. In the long answers, the very first thing you are having is, what is a combustible substance? So any substance which burns in air when a particular temperature is provided to it, then it is called as combustible substance. Example, wool, LPG, clothes, etc. What it is called as? A combustible substance. And what are its example? Its example are wood, cloth, then LPG. These are few examples. Coming to the next particular answer. Draw the well-labeled diagram showing four zones of the candle flame. The labeling also we need to do. This is the wick. This is the outermost layer where complete combustion takes place. Which is blue in color, then here you are having yellow in color, middle layer, where incomplete combustion takes place and you can see yellow flame. While this is the innermost layer, where it's totally appearing black because no combustion takes place. So these are the basic way, and in the bottom you are having over here some blue zone okay where the unburnt carbon particles are there. Okay, innermost layer, that is inner dark zone, generally it is called as. Outermost layer, which is the luminous zone, so that is blue colored flame here because it is complete combustion is taking place, while in middle incomplete combustion takes place. Okay, so I hope you are clear with the diagram. We have done also the diagram. Next, an electric spark is passed between two electrodes that are placed near each other tightly inside a tin or can which is filled with diesel or petrol. Will diesel or petrol catch fire? Give reason to support your answer. Petrol or diesel will not catch fire. Why they will not catch fire? Because it is totally packed. They have said that it is tightly closed. Because it is tightly closed, there is no supply of oxygen in it. There is no movement of air inside or outside it. So, the supporter of the combustion, that is air, is not available, and so there will be no spark. Here the spark will not be produced. Moving to the next part, how are fuels classified? Give two examples of each. You already know that fuels are classified as solid, liquid and gases, and the examples of it are solid fuel, liquid fuel, and gaseous fuel. If it's solid fuel, then example is wood, cow dung, your petrol, diesel. Your LPG, CNG, methane. So this is about the fuels classification. That is, they are classified as solid, liquid and gases, and their examples are stated over here. So I hope you are clear with the long answers, and in that only one answer is left out, which is name the various pollutants that are produced when combustion of fuel takes place. We'll do that, but before, you please note down this content. I hope you have noted it down. Then they have give the name of various pollutants that are produced by combusting the fossil fuel and the harmful effects that they are producing. Among them, the very first pollutant is smoke, because of which respiratory problems are there. Then it's carbon dioxide, which is again creating the respiratory problems that can lead to death. Then carbon dioxide. Now, how is carbon dioxide harmful to us? It will increase the atmospheric temperature and the greenhouse effect. That is the global warming. After carbon dioxide is oxide of sulfur that damage the lungs, produce acid rain. Next is oxides of nitrogen. This also causes acid rain. The next is lung congestion. So these are some of the problems that are occurring. This is the next answer. Then only names are there. Take the odd one out, and that you are having the very first one, which is LPG, petrol, water, kerosene, paper. Here only water is the thing which is non-combustible, other are combustible substance. So water, because it is non-combustible. Coming to the second question, petrol, biogas, kerosene, diesel and alcohol. Biogas is the gaseous fuel, rest are fuel in the liquids. The third one, which is oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide. It's called carbon monoxide because others are non-poisonous. Coming to the next, fourth question, acid rain, oxides of nitrogen, oxides of sulfur, carbon dioxide. It is carbon dioxide because it is not creating, taking any role play in formation of acid rain. Moving to the next answer, carbon monoxide, hemoglobin, incomplete combustion and nitrogen. So nitrogen is not at all related with the incomplete combustion. Rest are the results. Okay, this is about question D. Note down this content, then we'll move further on the last part, which is the definition, and there are four definitions. Be quick, note down the content, then we'll move further and we'll write the four definitions. quickly note it. I hope you have finished noting it. Now, moving to the next part, which is the four definitions. In that, the very first one is the ignition temperature. The minimum amount of temperature that is needed for the combustion to carry out, that is called as the ignition temperature. The lowest temperature at which substance catches fires. Is called ignition temperature. Second one, the second question is complete combustion. The combustion in which, whenever you are burning, for example, if the sufficient amount of oxygen is available, then the combustion is called as complete combustion. Coming to the next part. The next answer, which is fuel. What is fuel? A combustible substance that is on burning, producing large amount of heat and light. Heat and light energy is called fuel. The next question is calorific value. Calorific value is whenever you are burning, amount of energy, kitni energy mili, that is the calorific value. That is called as its calorific value. Okay, so please note it down quickly. So I hope you have noted down all the definitions. And with this, we wind up our today's session. Next time, we'll meet with the next particular chapter. That's all for today. Thank you so much for listening to me, and have a very good day. Bye-bye.